This was the scene in front of the Ateneo de Manila University on Tuesday. Students and youth groups called for an academic break. They also protested against the government's supposed botched disaster response. But an education official said such move may not be necessary. Speaking to 1PH, sa totoo lang, DepEd Undersecretary Diosdado San Antonio said there are existing guidelines for classes in the aftermath of calamities.
Ang mga existing guidelines natin, iba lang yung tawag, pero may suspension of classes naman automatic sa mga may typhoon signal. Pag hindi naman talaga posibleng magbigay ng lesson, hindi naman natin ginagawa.
San Antonio also defended the agency against criticisms on how it dealt with demands from learners and teachers during the pandemic. He insisted that the blended learning setup was necessary to prevent the spread of COVID-19. A private law school dean echoed the government's position regarding the appeal for an academic break.
Ang pag-aaral ay hindi dapat dinabaliwala. Parating na handoon. Protesting and education can go together. They are not mutually exclusive.
President Rodrigo Duterte himself did not take well the recent student strike in Ateneo. He slammed the students who participated in the move but singled out those from the University of the Philippines. Duterte went as far as accusing UP of being a hub for communist recruitment. He threatened to defund the premier state university.
Yung eskwela, UP, fine. Pag hinto kayo ng aral, I will stop defunding. Nandiyan niya lang, wala nang ginawa itong ganun, kundi mag-recruit ng mga komunista dyan. Tapos nag-aaral kayo, ang gusto ninyong binibira ang gobyerno. Masyado naman nakaswerte kayo.
In a statement, UP Vice President for Public Affairs Elena Pernia highlighted the institution's mission and denied its alleged links to communists. Lawmakers from both houses of Congress stressed that state universities and colleges are considered no-cut zones. Senate pro tempore Ralph Recto said that the best response to calls for an academic freeze is boosting funding for education. ACT Teachers Representative Franz Castro said the president has no business deciding the fate of UP since it is Congress that deliberates on the budget for SUCs. For News 5, Rhea Fernandez, We Are One News.